Hi everyone, it's Helen Horta here, founder of Form Help, and today we are going to look at the IR595, the paper version or the PDF version. So yesterday I did a video on how to apply online for your child's IRD number. Now, one of the challenges that I came across was I thought it was a bit unclear as to who was supposed to answer which question. So for example, me as the parent, as I'm filling out the form on behalf of my child, there were some questions there where I wasn't sure if it was asking for answers from my child or from me as the adult. So I found that very confusing, and I ended up doing the IR595 paper version instead of the online version. Okay, so for those who are doing the IR595 paper version, we'll go through that together. So what does it say here? It says, complete this form unless you are a non-resident or an offshore person. So if you are, then don't use this form, use the non-resident offshore individual IR742. So to apply for an IRD number for you or for a child in your care, use the applicant checklist on page 2. So that's the page after this, the form on page 3, and sign the declaration on page 4. So take the form with current supporting documents, documents that have not expired, for an in-person verification to an authorised Inland Revenue agent. And these are AA driver licensing agents or post shops. So you can take your documents to either one of these two places to be verified. So you must provide one original document from Category A. So you've got Category A here, and one original document from Category B. Category B documents here, with your application, as well as a legible photocopy of each of your documents. Okay, so what documents do you need? So for Cat A document, you need either a full NZ birth certificate issued on or after the 1st of Jan 98, a NZ passport overseas, an overseas passport with NZ residence visa granted by Immigration New Zealand, a NZ emergency travel document, a NZ firearm or dealer's license, a NZ refugee travel document, a NZ certificate of identity issued by the Department of Labour or Department of Internal Affairs, or a NZ citizenship certificate. So you need one of these CAT A documents. So if you are providing a passport, please photocopy the pages showing your photo, name, and NZ residency class visa granted by Immigration NZ. Let's look at the CAT B documents. So you need either a NZ driver license, NZ 18 plus card, NZ student photo ID card, a letter confirming registration as a student in NZ, an offer of employment letter from your employer on their company letterhead with start date of employment, a international driver's permit issued by a member country of the UN Convention on Road Traffic, or a overseas driver's license accompanied by an English translation completed by an LTNZ authorized translator if not already in English. So if this document is used, this is the two-star note, so we go to here. So this is in regards to the letter confirming registration as a student in NZ. So if this document is used, you must provide a document from CAT A that contains a photo. So just ensure you have at least one CAT A document and one CAT B document. So in my example, I would have a NZ passport and a NZ driver license. Number 3, so if the documents you provide are in another name, you must provide an original document that confirms how your name was changed. Example, marriage certificate, deed poll, change of name certificate, civil union certificate, and a legible photocopy of that document. Okay, number 4, if you are applying for a child who is in your care and they are under 16, you must provide for the child one original CAT A or B document and a legible photocopy, and for you, full proof of your own identity, an original doc and legible photocopy which shows the relationship between you and the child, if not already shown in the CAT A document for the child. Example, a NZ full birth certificate issued on or after the 1st of Jan 98 for the child. Court docs showing the child and caregiver names, example, adoption papers, parenting orders, guardianship orders, or a stat deck, IR595D, and you can download this from www.ird.gov.nz. Now note, if you're a parent of a new baby and you haven't registered their birth yet, you can apply for your baby's IRD number at the same time as you complete the birth registration form. You don't need to complete this form or provide verification at an authorised agent if you do this. Okay, number five, the completed application form will be kept by the person who verifies the application. So they will forward the application to Inland Revenue. You will receive your IRD number within 8 to 10 working days of Inland Revenue receiving your application. To receive your IRD through email and text message, please ensure you provide consent at question 8B. Okay, note, so complete each part of the form marked with the square. Do I need to go through all these notes? Nope, I'll get you look at the notes for those questions as you need. Okay, we will get straight into the application. Now let's just look at the applicant's checklist before we proceed to the application. Now, have you provided a current CAT A original document and photocopy? So make sure you have that and tick that off before you leave home to get your documents verified. Have you provided a current CAT B original document and photocopy or photocopies? Have you provided current photocopies of any additional documents? Have you provided linking documentation for the child? And have you completed your part of the application form? And have you signed the application? Now, just please ensure that you go through this checklist before you go and get your forms or your documents verified. Okay, let's get into the application. So we have here the IRD number, application, resident, individual. So please read the notes. Yep, so the notes just above there before you complete the section. Please complete this application using capital letters. Oh, okay. Don't use abbreviations. Please complete the application in blue or black ink. Oh, so I've made an error here. So in my application, which I submitted yesterday, even though I typed it out in the document, I did not use capital letters. I think they mainly do that if you're writing, maybe because it's easier for them to discern what each letter is when it's in caps. Okay, carrying on. Okay, so child under 16, if you are applying for a child, print your own IRD number here. So go ahead and put in your IRD number. So I'll just pretend this is mine, 456. So as the parent or guardian, I am applying, so I will put my IRD number in there. Okay, applicant information. Question 2, name of the applicant as shown on identity documents. So go in and put the child's name as per their ID document. So first name, surname, put in their title, put in their first names, their preferred first name, put in their surname. Again, put in their date of birth, month, day, month, year. Please tick to show if you are applying for an IRD number, requesting confirmation of your IRD number. So in my example, I would go applying for an IRD number. Previous name, if applicable. So I would just go ahead and just put in their name, even though there is no previous name, just to save any confusion. So again, the child's name, surname, but that's up to you. Okay, address information. So go ahead and type in the address. Address there, street address, suburb, town, city, country, postcode, and current postal address. So only if it's different from your home or street address. So if it's different, then put in the current postal address. But if it's the same, then leave it. Previous address. So this will help us to confirm your IRD number if one may have been issued previously. So I know that my child hasn't had one previously, but I will still go ahead and put in the previous address that we lived at. So go ahead, street address, suburb, town, country, postcode. Contact information. Now, my child does not have their own mobile number, so I will put in my mobile. I will put, and because they don't check their email, I will put in my email. And then consent. So for the purposes of this application, I consent to receiving my IRD number by email or text or both, depending on the contact information I have provided. I acknowledge that Inland Revenue will take all reasonable steps to reduce any risk of unauthorized access or release of confidential information, but can't guarantee emails won't be intercepted or read while in transit. So I would go ahead and explain this to my child and say, yes, you need to consent so that we can receive your IRD through my mobile number or my email. Go ahead and select consent. Tax exemption. Do you qualify for a temporary tax exemption on foreign income? I would just say no, because my child does not receive an income. Privacy, so meeting your, yep, so read through that privacy, and then declaration. So please read carefully before signing. I declare that the information in this form is true and correct. I authorize Inland Revenue to contact any agency that issued a document I've used in support of this application to verify the details of that document. For the purpose of this application, I've read the privacy statement above before signing this declaration. So originally I thought it was my child that need to sign this declaration, but after reading the notes, my interpretation was that it's my signature. So go ahead and sign in there, put in the date. Now it says, please complete the applicant checklist on page 2. Do not post your application to Inland Revenue. Take this form with current supporting documents to a verifier. Okay, so then the section below here, you don't have to fill in any of that because the either the AA or the post shop, they'll have somebody there who will verify this part. So they'll fill in all that, all the section here. They'll ensure that the documents that you have provided, whether, they're acceptable. So that's their parts there, and they'll make any notes there. Okay, so that is the form. It's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. And then if you are like filling it out digitally, like what I did, and you've got more than one child, you can either just open up a new tab, or you can press this reset form, which will delete everything from here, and you can just start with the next child. But I would probably just open up a new tab in case. I don't know, that's just me. Anyway, hopefully you have found this video helpful. Those who are applying for IRD numbers for their child or somebody in their care. And all the best with your application. And this is me, Helen Hortai, founder of Form Help. Have a great day, everyone. And thanks for listening.